qualche modo.
Good afternoon. So checking everyone sent Scott news, so you should all have that now. Ian's going to start the questions. Just a reminder that the broadcast part of the press conference, no social media posting. Daly's briefing is embargoed till 10:30 this evening. Like last time. Ian, do you want to get us started?
Hi.
Can I begin by getting your thoughts on the announcement that was made last night that Luka Modric is FIFA's player of the year?
I congratulate him personally last night because I saw him on the party and of course well deserved. I think he was fantastic in the last season, big achievement with Real Madrid and of course with Croatia in the World Cup, and then the plus that was our player, Tottenham player, and of course happy for him and of course if he received the award is because he deserved.
Do you think he is the best player in the world?
Doesn't matter if I think or not. Who bought and gave him the award is because they believe and the people believe that it was the best in the last season. That doesn't matter if I think or not.
Let's talk about playing Watford in the Carabao Cup. Home tie, but at Milton Keynes.
How
do you feel about
playing? I feel well because we are going to discover another place to play. And of course, it's a very nice town. 4 years ago, I saw Dele Alli playing again with 16, 17 year old against Manchester United. And look, a lot of very good memories. I think it's a beautiful town with an amazing stadium. I think, the option to play there is the only option that we had when we picked to play there, and we are going to try to win the game and enjoy the afternoon, of course.
I gather that Dele Alli was one of those people who was pushing the idea to play this match at
Dele Alli push?
Yeah, he said he thought it would be a good idea.
Yeah, one thing is that he told you or told someone that it's a good idea, and now he's pushing. He's never, no one player is going to push the club to make some decision. No, that is, of course, that he's happy to play in from his own town, but in that decision, Dele Alli wasn't responsible.
Did he have any say?
Him?
Yeah.
To me?
Yeah. Did he say anything about
that? Yes, he's happy. He's not so excited. Of course, he's the king of Milton Keynes.
What do you say, though, to those Tottenham fans who are not going to go because it's been played?
No, I think our fans feel very disappointed, like us all. The first is our chairman is so disappointed because today was a game to play in our new stadium. And of course, it's not our under control. But of course, I understand the fans that are so disappointed with the situation, but the players are disappointed, all the staff, all the people that work for the club. But the first is the chairman that cannot deliver on time the new stadium ready to play. I think, of course, I understand completely. The fans are not happy with that situation, but I think no one is happy, and we need to adapt ourselves and ours in this circumstance. And if we only complain and only we find excuse, it's difficult to move on the club. It's difficult to move on the team. It's difficult to find. And to feel strong, because if not, the human being is always to try to find excuses, and if you don't win, and for me it's in the opposite, it's try to be strong. I think all that situation need to make us stronger than before, and use that for the future to have the capacity to adapt in every circumstance that is going to be the team. But for me, I am positive. I want to be positive, and of course, I am positive because I am a person optimistic, and I am not going to blame. I am not going to complain because now we are going to play in Watford, Milton Keynes, and different venue. I think it's a great opportunity to discovery and to try to be strong and be strong in our mind, trying to play away from home in the consecutive second season, no, in that period.
If you can get through to the next round, and again, there's a problem playing, would you be happy to continue playing matches at home?
Yeah, first of all, we need to win. Of course, we respect Watford. He's doing very well, very good start of the season. Of course, it will be a tough game, but after, if we I wish and I hope to win, of course, after the draw, we are going to take the decision. If it's again, we are going to play, we need to play at home, and it's not possible to play in Wembley or in our new stadium, of course, more than happy to play again in Milton Keynes.
Okay, final question for tonight. You spoke recently about cows.
Yes.
What do you know about the cows?
Sure that we are going to be very well welcome, because you know, it's the sympathy from me and from them, because my respect to the cow, and I think we were talking before the press conference. No, I think it's a shock.
About the concrete cow.
The concrete cow, yes, and the runabout, no, runabout. I think it's fantastic. It's a fantastic city, and I have a few friends there that live there, and it's so close to here. It's only 40 minutes, 45 minutes. I think Milton Keynes is a great town, and I think it's. It's beautiful. When I was there, I enjoyed a lot.
How do you approach this competition in terms of your team selection? Is it an opportunity to make some changes, to give some game time to players who haven't been practicing?
Look, from the beginning of the season, we are doing changes, and we are making a lot of change. Premier League and different games, we're using different... For me, it's a squad game, squad competition. In 4 years, I think we played one final, we played two semi-finals, and that means that we always take all the competition very seriously and with the idea to win. And then if you lose, like last year against Manchester United, or the previous season against Chelsea, the semi-final or the final, in some circumstance against Chelsea too, I think, it's because you took or you take the competition very seriously. And for me, always the competition is about the squad, Premier League, Champions League, Capital One, FA Cup, and we have a strong squad and capable to everyone to play. And of course, the idea is to win tomorrow.
Did Paolo Gazzaniga play at Brighton at the weekend? You said he was your man of the match. You indicated that he would play against Watford. Nothing's changed on that
front? No, nothing changed because Hugo is still injured and Michel the same. And same position, so is going to play Paolo and, of course, Alfie and Brandon like in contention.
How far away are Michel Vaughan and Hugo Lloris?
We'll see after the next few days if they can arrive to be ready for Huddersfield, if not for Barcelona, if not for Cardiff, and if not for...
Do you think there's a good chance one of them will be fit for the weekend?
Look, we cannot change. The process is the process that they need time to recover, but we'll see. We'll see what happens in the next few days, and then I'm sure in the next press conference before Huddersfield I'm going to tell properly if they are with the possibility to play or come back to be ready again to compete.
You played Watford just 10 days ago. What can you take from that match into this one?
No, more than 10 days. More than 10 days. We play before the international break.
Yeah, yes. Yeah. apologies.
No, yes.
What,
no, I think.
What do you take from that?
No, we were watching only this game and another game that they play in the Carabao Cup against Reading that he rotated and changed the starting 11 complete, 11 players different, and using different system against Reading. We'll see what happens tomorrow if the coach or the manager decide to give the same player playing or to play with the same starting 11 or the same player or rotate like was against Reading and use different system. We are aware about that. Of course, a lot of things that you can take from our game that we play in Watford, but sure that it's going to be a complete different game because it's a different competition and we'll see the selection on the starting 11 is going to put on place.
Chrissy, just one more on last night, not about Luka Modric, but were you disappointed that neither Hugo Lloris, or a couple of goalkeeper, and Harry Kane, both of them, didn't feature in the team of the year? I mean,
yes, of course, I can understand our fans, and of course, for them, sure, it's a disappointment, but we are not responsible of the vote. We are not responsible to pick the player that is going to be reward. Only, I cannot say nothing because it's not in our hands to take to give the awards to the players, our players.
Regarding tomorrow night, probably both teams will be much changed. You said already what the word in the last round already. I'm not going to pick your team for you, but I presume you're going to make some changes.
It's like again Inter de Milan, again Brighton, we change five. Yes, I think it's a squad game, it's a squad competition, like all, but yes, of course. Sure, 5-6 changes for
the
game.
Do you think the value is the competition at all?
Why?
Only because, not wishing to incur your wrath as people deal with Inter Milan, but you know, when you have a cup competition, you want to get to win a trophy. You've got to battle your best 11, your best 11 players. And then I can't play every single one.
Yeah, but if you see how we lose the games in the previous season, you're going to see that we lose always with again big teams and of course that we want to win, but if you say to the same question to the manager of Watford, why they or he pick 11 different player against Reading with the risk to lose when they didn't play European competition. And we are involved in Champions League. We have ahead a lot of game. I think we rotate, trying to find the best solution to try to win games. But the obsession here in England is to try to disrespect the player that play in one or another competition. And for me, it's so difficult to understand. Sorry, it's nothing wrong again with the question, but always is if tomorrow play Paulo Gazzaniga, the competition that the FA Cup will play Sergio Aurier that play again Inter de Milan but no play again Brighton, it's like we disrespect the competition or we don't take the competition seriously. I think when Tottenham is going to play tomorrow, he's trying to go in to win, and when you sign player and you have 24 players in your squad, you need to respect all the players. If not, if they are not capable to play or give the possibility to play, or they give the possibility to show their quality, why you pay the salary, why you provide the food every day on the training session and the training ground. And I think it's, sorry, but for me, it's so difficult to understand why that obsession about when play one or another player. It's like, okay, all the manager want to lose, no one want to win, the competition in the Copa del Rey in Spain, if Real Madrid is going to play again, I don't know, and if they used to rotate Real Madrid, that don't want to win. I think it's crazy, the situation is crazy. And the problem sometimes is not from you, because I understand the fans, I understand you, but sometimes some people that play football and some people that was professional, that that is the opinion is similar, is difficult to understand, because when I was professional player and now manager, you need to understand that to deal with 24, 25 is not easy. To give the possibility to play to all the player always is so important, because they need to feel the confidence, the trust, and to they need to challenge that the player that they believe that are ahead of them. But on the end, for me, is about the squad, is about team. And if you want to win some competition, you can win or you can lose with one or with another. Sometimes are more important when you win a trophy. The player that not play too much, because they help to be better every day to the player that play the most. And I repeat again, I don't understand the obsession to ask about the player that are going to play one another competition, because I think when we are going to play tomorrow or Saturday or Wednesday or I don't know, always is Tottenham that is going to play, and you play your I think your prestigio, how se dice? Prestige? Your honor. And when play Tottenham, no play one or another name. But of course, understand that you and everyone need to find some reason always to talk. And on the end, if we win, fantastic, to rotate, to give rest. If you don't give rest, it's because you don't give rest and you kill the player. And it's normal. If no play, the player that no play too much is a disrespect. Very disrespectful for the coach, and always with the magazine of Monday, it's easy to give opinion, and of course, but that is my show, but this is my contract, it's my job to try to deal with everything.
Mauricio, hi. A few questions for me. Just know, were there injury concerns heading into this game?
Hugo, Michel. Yes,
what I was going to say to you as well was we saw Maurizio Sarri last week give Eden Hazard the night off for his good performances against Salonika in Europe, and told to stay at home and rest and kind of recover. Is there anybody that you're not considering for this game that you think is quite a heavy schedule? You've got a lot of players who are in the final stages of the World Cup.
Yes, of course we are going to rotate. I was in Inter de Milan. I think we have the plan to give some another player rest. Yes, of course.
Okay. Approaching the game at the NK Dons Arena, how do you approach this in a stadium that you've never played in? Even down to small details like the dressing rooms and the pitch size and stuff, is there a lot of planning that goes into that ahead of that game?
Of course, for Watford will be the same, same condition and us. We are going to try to adapt to our game and try to give our best and try to win the game. And it's not an excuse to play in Milton Keynes. I don't want to put excuse. I don't want to say nothing again negative, because for me, like I told before, I am so optimistic and I'm very positive. And the circumstances are the circumstances. We cannot change the circumstances, and of course we need to be clever and to be positive in the tough period that is now for the club. I think the last season was tough, and now it's tough because I think it's tougher because the circumstances, and because not only the circumstances, if not the expectation was to play in our new stadium, and that is for the fans, for everyone, is so disappointed and so frustrated for many people, but it's so important from inside to keep strong and believe and try to be positive. Of course, it's the circumstance that no one wanted, but we need to keep pushing. If not, we cannot go down, and say, okay, because the circumstances are not the circumstances that we expect. If we lose, it's because of the circumstances, it's because we play in Milton Keynes, it's because the stadium is not ready, because we need to play again in Wembley. And I think it's easy to blame all this, but I don't want to blame. I want to be responsible of the result. I want to be responsible about the performance. When I am happy, I tell you, and when I'm not happy, I tell you too. The relationship with the player, and I think it's a more healthy relationship. And of course, it may be tough now, but sure, it's going to be good for the future because the stadium is building a fantastic venue to play football. The facilities here, I think. The potential and the future of the club is massive.
You touched on it there about the effects it's going to have on the players. I mean, how unsettling is it for the players and yourself to have to, go up to Milton Keynes and the fact that you don't know where you're going to be playing from the end of November?
Look, if one thing I don't want and I didn't want, is to give reason to the player, to us, to say, okay, if we don't win, it's because we don't win. It's because we don't play in our stadium. It's because we play on Wembley. I think I am not like this. If we lose because we deserve to lose, because we don't play well, and because our performance is not good, or because I made a mistake, it's my responsibility, it's our responsibility. But for me, if you are a winner, you have different mentality. And if you are a loser, you always find excuse and try to avoid the responsibility. I don't want to give. Of course, that I understand that it's not the same to play in your home and all clear for our fans, and the help from the fans will be fantastic in our new stadium, and the atmosphere and the energy is different to play in Milton Keynes than play in your own stadium. But I don't want to find excuse. We need to go there and try to show personality and character and win the game. That is our responsibility. If we don't win, it's because it was our responsibility. It's not to blame the venue or to blame the fans or to blame the chairman or to blame. No, when we are on the pitch, we are on the pitch. And then it's 11 by 11 and we need to be clever and better than the opponent. That's it. I understand football like this, and I am like this, like a person, my character and my personality, and of course I understand all that happened around, but I try to avoid that the player find excuses with no performance in the way that we need to perform.
And in terms of the fans, how much sympathy do you have for them having to pay up to go to Milton Keynes and they bought tickets for the new stadium and they don't know when they're
going
to be able to get there?
Yes, I think I am the first that I would like to finish the stadium. I promise you, if I need to go to work after training here and help to the builders to finish the stadium as soon as possible, for the fans will be happy and for all the players happy, and of course the chairman sure will be happy. I promise I go. But I think I told in the past when there was the decision that because wasn't ready the in the day that we expect to be ready to play against Liverpool, that was so disappointing for our fans. I need to tell them sorry. I need to tell that we are doing all that we can to try to finish. And I think the chairman is so commitment and I promise he didn't sleep trying to find solution. And of course that we feel disappointed for our fans. But they need to understand that it's a venue for the rest of our life and for the next generations and years, and it's so important to finish in the right way. And maybe 1 month means a lot, or 2 months, but on the end, it's not time. Because the most important is to finish in and to be safe when we are going to move there. Fans happy, player trying to give the best, their best to try to win in games, and in the future to have a venue that help us to win trophies. Because I think Tottenham future with these facilities, with this that venue to play, the stadium that will be one of the best. Only we are going to miss to win the trophies in the, ¿cómo se dice? En la sala de trofeos. In the cabinet. Yes, only we are going to miss again. But we need to start to put trophies there. Yes, of course, because the best training ground, the best stadium, the best fans. Okay. Not so good manager, not so good coaching staff. Great players, only trophies. We need to add to the history of the club.
Ali, last one, please.
Can I just ask you one player who might feature tomorrow, Juan Foy? He's had a tough start to the season, the injury, and obviously then there wasn't room for him in the championship.
He's going to be on the squad.
How have you, has it been difficult to manage his situation this season?
No, it's not difficult. It's true that it was a little bit, very bad luck, because he got injured the day before to go to USA. And it was longer, the recovery. Now he's doing well, he's going to be on the squad. I don't believe that he's going to play, but he's going to be on the squad.
There's reports coming out of Argentina that he might actually be called up for the next international squad. Is that too early for him? Because he hasn't even played a Premier League game yet.
Look, only I can tell you that some coaching staff contact me, asking about his form and how was he was doing, and I don't know if he's going to be called or not, called for the national team. But in the last months, in the last international break, some staff contacted me. Yes.
Camps off. Thank you.
Thank you.